fun fall. Introducing first from Houston, Texas, Kaitlyn.
Welcome back to FCW. We have got the winner of NXT Season 3, the lovely Kaitlyn, about to face off with one of the most dangerous divas we've ever seen in FCW. Rosa Mendes, the queen, will be out momentarily, but right now, Kaitlyn is red hot in the WWE universe.
And her opponent, she is the FCW queen, Rosa Mendes.
Rosa Mendes beat AJ a few weeks ago to fulfill a two-year quest to become the queen of FCW.
Yeah, I'm glad you mentioned that, Matt, because if I had any role, if I had any vote, Rosa Mendes would be my choice for Inspirational Superstar of the Year.
Thankfully, that power doesn't lie with you, Byron.
Well, maybe it should. Think about it. They've almost 2 years pursuing the crown, and there she is, finally, the queen, our illustrious queen of fourth championship wrestler.
Byron, anybody involved in FCW knows the value of persistence, but in Rosa's case, I think persistence has turned to psychosis. She is obsessed with that crown.
Wait, wait, so you're saying someone is psycho because they have a goal and work hard to achieve it?
No, I don't think that at all. But you were sitting at this very announce desk when Rosa had her many attempts to become the queen of FCW.
So then what you're saying is that if you have several attempts and are unable to achieve your goal, then you should just quit.
What I'm saying is Rosa Mendes seemed to get a little more deranged each time she was unable to attain that crown, the title of the queen of FCW.
Let me ask you a question.
Yes, Byron.
Have you ever won a championship in your life?
No, I have never won a championship in my life.
Just end it right there. We've got our question answered. Go on.
Rosa Mendes, one of the featured top divas in FCW. Oh, big backdrop. And I got to think the strength advantage in this matchup goes to Kaitlyn, but Rosa Mendes, a rather wily veteran in the Divas division, not only in FCW, but on WWE programming as well. Oh, Kaitlyn able to kick out right there.
You got to believe this is also a SmackDown rivalry here between Rosa Mendes and Kaitlyn.
Hard kick to the back from Rosa. Rosa not content, I would have to think, to be the dominant diva in FCW. She wants to dominate the entire WWE universe. There's what I was talking about earlier. Did you see the look on Rosa's face when things didn't go in her favor? She's turned a corner and she's flipped that switch from normal to slightly off balance.
Would you agree that Kaitlyn's a very suitable competitor and a very tough opponent?
Absolutely.
Okay, then. So wouldn't Rosa Mendes have to dig deep and discover that inner part of her soul to be that much better?
I'm not saying that that's the wrong thing to do.
It sure sounds like it to me.
Rosa's interesting behavior has got to be a huge part of why she was able to become queen of FCW. But Rosa taking a little too long, in my opinion, at this point.
She's having fun.
Big suplex from Rosa. Byron, the FCW divas have to be seen to be believed. And if you'd like to see them in person, go to fcwwrestling.com to find out when FCW will be coming to a town near you. We have live events all over the state of Florida featuring WWE superstars, FCW superstars, NXT rookies, and the breathtaking divas.
Will you be there?
I will be there. I'm always there, Byron.
And I may get sick.
Right now, Rosa taunting Kaitlyn.
She's teaching Kaitlyn a lesson. You know, Kaitlyn, many folks think that Kaitlyn might have had things handed to her a bit. Having won NXT, you know, getting shipped over to SmackDown, you know, maybe she didn't have to pay the dues that a Rosa Mendes had to pay. And right now, she's taking it out on her.
Kaitlyn had to endure so much at the hands of her pro, Vicky Guerrero. It's a testament, in my opinion, of the toughness that Kaitlyn displays outside and inside the ring. She's got mental toughness along with the physical toughness. But when you miss a big move like that, it may not count. Rosa right on the attack. Rosa taking her time right now. She knows she's got Kaitlyn at the disadvantage.
Oh, there's insult to injury. Pulling the hair of another woman.
Rosa not making any bones about it. She's got a handful of hair right in front of the referee's face.
Well, I say unless the referee stops her, she's got every right.
What's Kaitlyn got Rosa set up for right here? Rosa looks like she's scared out of the electric chair drop. And Rosa fell on the back of her head. It looked like Kaitlyn might have caught a little bit of that too. Can the queen make it to her feet, or is the NXT season 3 rookie created an opportunity for herself right here?
The race is on here. The crown is not on the line, but certainly if Kaitlyn can pick up a win here, that speeds her right up to contendership there.
No question about that. Big clothesline from Kaitlyn and a back elbow. The queen goes flying. Kaitlyn muscles the queen up. Rosa crashing down and Kaitlyn going for a cover. This could be it. One, two, no. Rosa just kicks out.
See the strength from Kaitlyn from her competitive fitness days. See now she can translate that into this matchup here in FCW.
Rosa's got the experience though. She knows how to change momentum.
Yes, there's your momentum change.
Rosa going for a big clothesline. Kaitlyn, flatliner.
What? Rosa.
No, Kaitlyn got it done.
Here's your winner, Kaitlyn.
Kaitlyn is victorious over the queen of FCW. I agree with you, Byron. This has got to put Kaitlyn right at the top of the contenders for that crown.
Well, I'm impressed. I mean, Kaitlyn, in her short career, has done so much so soon, and now capturing a victory over the queen of FCW in Rosa Mendes.